Welcome to Stoughton Media Access Cable's Community Forum Show. My name is Steve Kelly, and I have the privilege of bringing you, right in the background as you can see, a sneak preview of the Little Theatre of Stoughton's Hercules production. It's a great group of kids. We're here at Stetson Hall in Randolph. We've got a show coming up March 3rd, 4th, and 5th. And we hope you can attend, and we think that the show we put together for you is going to make you want to attend. So let's give a listen right here in the background.
You're not hearing me. If you're ever in a pickle, you can call for me in Pickle. I'm fat, Sarah.
Not in a pickle.
You would be in steam for any dream or in speed. That's how it should be done. Stay in the background, just smiling every now and again. Just to be a pretty lady, that would be a pity for you. Maybe you're right.
So, hi, I'm with Alana McDermott. Yep. Alana, you're playing the role of Hercules.
Yep.
Okay, so that's not a stretch for you. You seem like the really strong person. So tell us why that you love that play. Why do you love that part?
Hercules, it was such an honor to hear that call. I didn't know what to say when I got that call. I was like, oh my goodness, really? And yeah, I read the script, and as I was highlighting my lines, I said to myself, oh my goodness, this character is kind of like me. And I feel like because they wrote the show, they kind of based the characters off of the actual people who play the roles. And
wow.
Yeah.
It's so they reinvented the role almost matching you?
Yep.
Now tell me about Persephone. I mean, what a pain in the dupa.
Goodness.
So tell me about what?
She will not stop popping up everywhere I go. Sarah usually refers her as the baker's wife from Into the Woods.
Yes.
And me as the baker.
Yes.
Because the baker's wife, she'll do everything in her power to help the baker. And that's what Persephone wants. She just wants to help her older brother through his journey to become a god.
That older brother wants to get her away.
Yep. Hercules, I feel like he's a little bit of a narcissist. He thinks that he can do it on his own, no help necessary, and he declines help many times throughout the show.
In this play, I think it's disproven that he can do it on his own.
Yep.
Yes.
It's definitely disproven.
Yeah. He almost make a fool of himself so many times.
He does. There's in the first scene with Prometheus and Hercules, he's holding his map upside down and holding his sword wrong, and then he does not know how to use a sword. And then when he's with Meg trying to rescue her.
Yes.
It just doesn't go so well.
It doesn't go so well, and he's not able to do pretty much anything on his own.
No.
And he has, like, how many things does he have to conquer? Five,
he
ten, right?
12 labors.
12. He has 12. And what do you call those 12 things?
They're 12 labors to become a god.
12 labors to become a god. Yeah. So we don't want to tell too much about the show, but what about singing in the show? Do you do any singing?
I do a lot of singing in the show. It's a musical, and so I have one big solo, which is Go the Distance, which is in the movie as well, and that's really fun to sing.
Can you do like an excerpt from that?
I can try. I have often dreamed of a far off place where a great warm welcome will be waiting for me, where the crowds will cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be. I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I will go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
Wow, that's fabulous.
Thank you.
And you could even do it like right off the cuff without any warning.
Yeah, I was like, I've been practicing it a lot at home as well.
Well, I'm glad you've been doing the practice. It's obvious. It really came off well.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you said that there was a little handicap in this play in that you weren't able to even practice for the first month.
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
So I was in two other productions at this time, Elf Junior, which was at BC High, and the Big Bad Musical, which was with South Shore Theatre Works, and that was performed here. And so Big Bad Musical went through the beginning of summer, that's when the auditions happened, through January, And so then after, I went straight into Hercules. I started highlighting my lines, printing out my script, and my friend Isabel and I, we were both in that production, so we had to learn all the dances and catch up with everyone else. But it was really fun to do it all.
How many times do you think you've gone over your lines just in the last, say, 6 weeks?
I've definitely been running Act 1 a lot, and I almost have that down. Act 2, today, it was just Act 2 during school. Every time I had a break, I would look at my lines and start memorizing.
So it's a difficult task then, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what would you say to someone who is trying to learn their lines? What are your tricks?
My tricks are, I usually read over the scene without blocking, and then I put my hand over all of the lines and slowly scroll down them. And if I miss a highlight, I say, oh, gotta go back. And sometimes I have to go back to the beginning of the scene.
So you read the scene and then you have to sort of announce your lines as you,
mm-hmm.
and if you miss it coming, then you go, okay, gotta go back and read the scene again.
Yep.
So that's a great little trick.
Yeah,
so
it's really fun as well, because you can also imagine different ways of speaking the line. We did an exercise, I forget where, I think it was at South Shore Theater Works, where you would say the line three times, and each line, and each time you said it, you would have to say it in a completely different way.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, what color are you in this show? Because I think, are you orange? Did I hear that?
I think I'm orange.
You think
Hercules
you're orange?
Is an orange color.
Orange, yeah. So Sarah was sharing with us that you really worked hard on, like, creating an orange character for strength.
Ooh.
So what are the, like, do you like wear extra muscles when you do this? is it all like out of your character that you do this?
It's all out of character. Really, sometimes during shows, it's not about the appearance of someone, not how tall they are or short. It's about how they portray that character. It's how they express it, and it's how they deliver each and every line.
That sounds great. So would you just give a little encouragement to people watching on this preview and tell them that you'd like them to come see the show?
Guys, come see the show. It's going to be amazing.
All right, so March 3rd, 4th, and 5th.
Yep.
Here at the Stetson Hall in Randolph.
Mm-hmm.
Come on down. All right, thank you very much.
Thank you
Alana,
so much.
Great job on the interview.
Thank you.
All right.
You want to do the whole thing?
Never turn back.
here with my granddaughter, Elle, and with Bella Coe. And Elle, what are we here to do?
We're interviewing Bella Coe, and she is playing...
What's the name?
Megra.
Megra. What is Megra?
Megra is Hercules' leading lady.
Wow. So, all right. So tell us all about it, Bella Coe. What is Megara's role?
Megara is technically Hercules' girlfriend. She is his...
Now, wait a minute. Technically, is that like...
Technically.
What is technically? Is that like you're in the eighth grade, right? Is that what you tell your dad? Like, technically, he's not my boyfriend? What do you mean by technically?
Technically means that in the beginning of the show, she doesn't like him, but at the end, she's head over heels for him.
Wow. But what did he do in the beginning?
In the beginning, he wasn't a hero. In the song Zero to Hero, it says that he went from zero to hero, basically, being like not strong, not even knowing who he was, really, and sprouting into a brave man.
Wow. And so what drew you to that particular role? How was it you were lucky enough to have landed the role?
I love the Disney movie Hercules, and my favorite song from that movie was I Won't Say I'm in Love, and that's the song that Megara sings. So I've always like technically like loved Megara, and I feel like she's like the first like Disney feminist character that really stuck out to me. So that's why I really wanted to go for her.
Now we just want to input technically, this isn't a Disney production, right? So we could introduce that Kelly McGrath sort of brought her own adaptation of the Disney Hercules movie.
She did. I'm trying to play it different than Disney. So I'm trying to like incorporate different elements into her personality, and I feel like that's going really well in the show.
So tell us a little bit about how many shows you've been in before this. What got you ready to take on a leading lady role?
So I've been in many little theater shows before, maybe about 10 shows now, maybe more, and I've just been with them for a long time, and I've loved all the parts that I've gotten in all the shows. So it just really makes me like at home here to be in a production with them. So I really enjoy it.
Wonderful. So Elle, do you have any questions for Bella?
Yes, I do. How did you magically like her, Megra, or did you just naturally like her just anyways?
So as soon as I watched the movie, I knew I loved her because she was a little sassy and she was really funny, and I loved all of her songs, so I just thought that she was like a great character overall.
So now you mentioned that you didn't really like Hercules, but we didn't find out, does Hercules like you?
Yes, he does.
From the beginning?
As soon as he sees me, yes.
Yeah? And does he fight you off and pretend or what?
Well, I guess we're going to have to watch the show and see what happens.
Very good answer. Okay. Would you also tell the audience when is the show and where would they get tickets?
Tickets are available at littletheatreofstoughton.org, and the show is on March 3rd, 4th, and 5th.
And where is it?
It's here at Stetson Hall at, what's the ad?
Randolph, right?
In Randolph.
Right in Randolph Center. And we want to give a little shout out to the trustees of Stetson Hall, who give such a reasonable rate to the Little Theatre of Stoughton to come. They get to rehearse here, and you can hear them in the background. So tell us a little bit about what's going on in the background.
Right now, they are doing the group number. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. It's the number where Prometheus, who is Hercules' friend, is training him how to fight against all the monsters.
Yes. I really like the themes in the story. It seems like it's just like life, where there's so many things that you battle in life, and it shows Hercules coming of age through those battles.
I agree.
And you identified in that. Well, thank you very much for being on our interview.
Thank you for having me.
Hi, I'm here with Sarah Flanagan. Sarah, I feel like you're an old pro now. I've interviewed you a number of times, and you are here as the sort of the co-executive producer.
Sure.
Of the show, all right? That's a good
title.
We do
a lot of random things, so we'll make one up.
All right. So then, but you're actually coordinating the event.
Yes.
Right, along with Kelly McGrath?
Yes, okay. Kelly McGrath, yeah.
And she is the person who sort of redesigned, adapted this beautiful Hercules theme into something slightly different than Disney.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah. She took the Hercules myth, like the Greek mythology, and made it more historically accurate and then brought it up to date. She did a lot of work on it.
Historically accurate and then kind of stretching it a little from historically accurate.
Yes.
Yes. So what makes this one special? I mean, you've done 20, let's say. And what are the special challenges that you've had pulling this one together?
This biggest one is probably that the kids don't know the music. Like, so it's not something that they could buy a CD for and will have known this music.
Oh.
These are music from all different
parts. Not like Frozen, where everybody knows all the lyrics.
Right, and you can buy the CD and it's like Frozen. No, this is like songs from a bunch of different shows, a bunch of Broadway shows from the early time, like these kids have just never heard of. So it was challenging for them to get to learn it really quickly without having so much material to look at.
And you have, now Alana, is she Hercules?
Alana's Hercules, yes.
Okay. And why did Alana fit that role?
So interesting, no one wanted Hercules.
No one.
And no one auditioned and wanted the part. So usually we kind of have somebody who's like, oh, I really would like a lead, and we kind of give them a chance, but no one wanted it. So we had to place everybody else differently, and it was like a big board. We had a big board and everyone's names. But Alana just really brought this like kind, determined character. She has beautiful stage presence, and she was just a great fit. So we called her first to make sure she would take the part.
Yes.
And she said yes, thank goodness. So then the rest of our cast worked. But yeah.
Wonderful. Now, I think what you do is absolutely magic, all right? And if I'm having a parent look at this interview, I want them to know how special you treat their kids. Tell me about that.
So the kids, this is like a second family. Really here, like I grew up doing Little Theatre. Kelly like was born into Little Theatre.
Yes.
She's doing it longer than me. But these kids, most of these kids are the ones that we've had for years, and now they're, you know, we have like Vandy, who's now a senior in high school, started without a few years ago, and watching these kids grow up is just really nice.
I think that what you do is, I mean, we don't get a lot of pay when we do volunteer work, right?
Yeah, no pay. No pay.
So, but you're so dedicated. I think it's fabulous. I really
Thank
do.
Thank you.
I mean, that's so much work on behalf of the kids. What do you get out of it? What makes it special to you?
It's a lot of just giving back to the community that I grew up in, like the arts community of Stoughton.
Yeah.
And just building a foundation. A lot of these kids don't have theater in schools, so this is kind of their only exposure. It's very affordable for them to do it as well. Some other places, it's, you know, it's also a money thing. It's a timing thing. And so we're able to provide that a little differently here.
So if a family wanted to join you, is there like a cost that you could kind of share?
Yep, so each year they pay a participation fee just to be in the show, a membership fee to Little Theatre of Stoughton.
Yep. Right.
So I think it's $50 and it costs, take costs for the whole year. So
That's
just kind of working with that budget as well.
So give us the 1, 2, 3, the things you're going to teach them first, second, and third. When they just they come into you, they don't know anything. What do you say, like timing, singing, organization, or what sort of thing?
We did a lot of character work with this one and a lot of looking back with like Greek mythology and characters and color work. We did a lot of colors.
What is that?
So something I did in grad school and like learned about, I never used it before, but it was like each character is going to identify with a color, each one of the main characters, and the rest of the characters are going to be in white. So each of the main characters has their own color. So for example, like Hercules, I believe, is orange, and orange stands for, you know, strength and all of this. So we did background and, you know, colors and characters and how they all interact and how they have relationships with each other to build that foundation. And then we went into the script. So we're kind of a little behind because we spent so much time on it, but I think hoping it will pay off in the end. And most of this show is an ensemble piece, which means that there's only a handful of characters who are the big, big leads, you know, like Hercules and Meg and Hera and Zeus. And then we have a lot of kids who are ensemble, who still have lines. All these girls have lines, and boys, they have lines. They're playing different characters through the whole show. So it's going to be really cool, and they have really fast costume changes, and it's really a piece where there's no small part in this show. They're on stage the whole time, so it's going to be adventurous.
So as we close the interview, make an appeal to the audience to come.
Yeah, come see Hercules.
Okay.
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. It has a lot of heart. And these kids have worked so hard. They really have worked so hard here and at home, and taken the time out and just really fell in love with the story.
And by the way, I can actually see that, like, glistening in your eyes, that you're, how serious you are and how wonderful the job you're doing. And I hope the audience can sense
that.
Come on down and have a look.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Well, thank you for the interview.
Thank you.
All right, back to work for you.
Yes.
Okay.
Then your song. What's your song?
No.
No, we're not going to do that one.
I'm here with Emily Russell, and she plays Persephone. Okay? So why are you playing Persephone?
It's actually what the part that I wanted, so I was very happy when they, like, said I got it.
Yes.
And she's actually a lot like me. I have a brother, and I like to follow him around. And when his girlfriend's over, I always like to bug them.
Oh, my goodness. He must hate that.
Yeah, he does.
So you already have practice at being that in real life.
Yes.
That's good. Is this the first, like, that's a big part in this play. Is this your first big part?
Yes. And it's actually my first female part.
And your first female part, which is even more exciting.
Yeah.
Right? Can be like a build up to the next big part.
Yeah.
But Persephone, so what do you do that's special to make Persephone come to life for the audience?
Well, I actually just follow him around, and he thinks I'm not really that strong or anything, but I think I'm really, like, big and strong and better than him, even though he's very strong.
If you were to read the script, you'd realize that he needs your help a lot.
Yes.
Yeah. So what's going on in his life that he needs this little sister to keep pulling him out of trouble?
Well, the first time, he has these, like, girls that always are following him.
It sounds like what you said about your brother.
Yes. And I help them go away, and I think they're super annoying, like, really annoying.
Yeah.
And then the first time he finally says that I need you is when this person, his name is Mr. Boar, and he does not stop talking. And it's just like he bores everybody.
Oh.
And I tie him up in a rope and like make him stop talking.
That sounds like so much fun for you.
Yes. Yes. Very fun.
Very fun. Wonderful. So what got you into acting or actressing? I'm not sure if that's a word.
Actually, my grandmother, she used to, like, sing and dance, and, like, I've never met her, so it really like helps me connect to her when I sing and dance.
Is it your grandmother on your mother's side or on your...
On my dad's side.
On your dad's side. And he must love that you're doing that.
Yeah, he does. Yeah? He loves hearing me sing.
Yeah? And so do you sing like a solo in the show, or do you sing like right with everybody else?
I have a solo song. It's called Right Hand Man.
Ah.
And it's actually from Something Rotten.
Oh. That doesn't sound good, Something Rotten.
Oh, yeah.
But it is something really good? And do you love that song? Have you like embraced it?
I love that song. It's so much fun. It has like ups and downs. And
now, is your brother? Do you think your brother's gonna come see the play?
Yes.
Yeah. How old is he?
He's 21.
He's 21, and
yes.
He must be. When he sees this show and the part you have, he's gonna be like, "She's perfect for this."
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's great. So, do you have like a message you want to send to like your mom or your dad?
Well, thank you for letting me, for everything that you've done and, like, paying LTOS for.
Yeah.
And thanks for buying my
sandals. Dropping you off 100 times and picking you up 100 times.
Yeah. And buying my sandals, too.
Yeah.
That's one thing that's
That's a big thing for the show. You got to have the right sandals for the show.
And, thank you for, like, always supporting me and what I do, so...
That's going to be fun. So, do you have any big college plans? Are we way too young for that?
I want to go to New York City.
Uh-huh.
So, I want to go to college in New York.
Yeah. And then maybe, like, try to do some drama and things like clubs and stuff like that?
And actually, my dream role is actually I'm Glinda on Wicked.
Okay.
It used to be Annie from Annie, but I got too old for that, so I had to pick anyone.
You got too old for it. Oh, doesn't that stink?
Yeah. I was really disappointed.
Yes, you were really disappointed. But at least you can do Persephone?
Yes.
Yes. Good. And have you done another show, or is this your first?
I have done many other shows at LTOS.
Many other shows.
Yes. My first show was Annie with them. I was like 4.
And you were 4. So is your strongest suit, do you think, your voice or your ability to project, or what is it?
I think my voice. Yeah. I like singing a lot, so.
Do you? Can you do like a little tiny sing right now?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, go ahead.
From Right Hand Man or?
Sure, Right Hand Man.
If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double to bail you out. If there's anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about.
Wow, that is so wonderful. I bet you're gonna be an all-star in the show.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming on with us. And I wish you a lot of luck. What do they say? Break a leg?
Yes.
So break a leg.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Very nice. It's a pleasure.
If you ever got in trouble, I would be there on the double to bail you out. If you anything you lack, you know I've always got your back. That's what it's all about. Think of me as your sidekick. Help me.
So if you've just tuned in, I'm here with the 3 muses of Hercules. So what are the uses of the muses? Tell me.
We're basically the narrators of the story, and we sing a lot. So yeah.
So this is Vandy.
Yes.
And you're Jenna.
I'm Jenna, yeah.
And that's Allie.
Yes.
Right? So what is it that a muse, you say that you're the narrators or the tellers of the tale. How do you do that?
Well, a lot of the times we're in the background of different scenes, kind of like reacting to things, and there's also a couple like lines before, and we are kind of explaining what's going on and stuff, and a lot of the songs the same thing, kind of narrating it, so, yeah.
So, Allie, if you could grab the mic. So, Allie, tell me, like, what's the most surprising thing that the muses, the 3 muses, come across in the show?
Honestly, there are a lot of surprising parts of the show. There's a lot of twists and turns. I don't want to spoil anything if you all want to come see it, but it's very interesting and you all should come.
So pick, if you would, one particular scene that you guys like. And maybe, Jenna, can you identify?
I really love all the songs we do. They're so fun. They're upbeat. I really love Zero to Hero, which is in the second act. It's in the second act, and it's towards the beginning, and it's such a fun song, and it's just so fun to sing, and we agree. We all love it, and like, it's a really fun dance.
I want to hear a couple of stanzas of Zero to Hero. So you ready? So you can...
Beginning.
Sure. See if you can get close enough to the microphone.
Okay.
All right. This is great.
Herc was on a roll.
First sin of the week in every Greek opinion poll.
What a pro, Herc could stop a show.
Pouring a man a monster in your talking and sorrow.
He was a no one.
A zero, zero.
Now he's a hot shot.
He's a hero.
He was a kid with his act down pat.
From zero to hero in no time flat.
Zero to hero.
Just like that.
Wow, you guys are great.
Thank you.
Wow, and it's almost like your voices are matched. Did they pick you to match, it was really like harmonized.
Yeah. I don't know what they did to pick us, yeah. But
boy, do you guys click.
Yeah, we work really well, and we're trying to like put our voices together in a good way and make it sound good.
And your timing, you mentioned earlier as we were talking off camera that you really have to work your timing, and boy, you were snapping that. Yeah. So you must be very excited.
Yeah.
So is this, like, for you, Vandy, for your first show, your 10th show, I mean, you're a senior in high school?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah? So have you done more of these?
This is my 6th show.
Okay.
With it, and it's my last junior show.
Oh.
So, yeah, I'm sad to leave, but I'm trying to enjoy it while I can.
It seems like you've got two partners that are going to really pull with you.
Yeah.
Tell us about your plans. What, you're going to go to college?
Yeah, I'm going to college. I don't know which college yet, but...
Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah. So, but will it be one that has a focus with drama, do you think?
I'm not going to major in theater, but I want to do it as an activity, so...
That'll be great. Yeah. And you are both, Jenna, you're still quite a bit away from that.
Yeah, I just start freshman year, so I'm like opposite of her. She's ending and I'm starting. So
okay. So do you expect to do more with the Little Theatre of Stoughton?
We'll see what happens. I just started doing drama club at Canton High. I'm in Hairspray right now at the same time too.
Yep.
So everyone should come see that too. But so we're gonna see what the future brings in the next shows they do. But yeah, this is my my 6th show with Little Theater.
Wow.
So I started in like 6th grade and I've been going on. So I'm just gonna see what they offer next and see what goes on after that.
Ellie, tell us a little bit about what it's like to work with Sarah and the rest of the people directing or sort of co-producing the show.
Working with Sarah and Kelly and all of the fantastic crew of the show is really fantastic because they help us learn our songs and our lines, and they really make sure we know what we're doing, and they help us if we ever have any problems with anything, and it really helps bring the show together and make it even better than it would have been without them.
I have to tell you, if your little audition for us is a predictor of the show, it's going to be an amazing show. That was just so beautiful. It really was. I mean, there's no fakery here. I was like, whoa, this is fabulous.
Thank you.
So that's good. So why don't you invite the audience as a close to our little interview to come see you on March 3rd, 4th, and 5th.
Yes.
So go ahead, say something that gets them in.
Come see Hercules.
March 3rd, 4th, and 5th at Stetson Hall.
Make sure you make to the show. It's fantastic. I love sharing the stage with these ladies. See you there, hopefully.
Nice job. Thanks very much for being on the interview.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Into lunch shop, they call.
most of us have a best friend. And with our new guest, Isabel Asaf, she is going to share why she's a best friend of Hercules. So, Isabel, why are you the best friend? What makes you a best friend for Hercules?
Well, pretty much when Hercules starts his adventure, he really has no talents. He's really only got his strength. He has no like sword fighting skills or any fighting skills at all. So Prometheus is able to teach him how to sword fight and actually helps him maybe get stronger even. Helps him become the hero he becomes in the end of the story. So
you're Prometheus, right? And do you sing during this?
I sing three songs in the show. I sing Somebody's Got Your Back, which is a song I sing with Hercules. It's not where you start, it's where you finish, whereas where I teach Hercules how to fight and tell her where basically it's where me and Persephone try to get Hercules and Meg back together after an argument.
Wow. So that's kind of a big task, isn't it? I mean,
yeah.
They have a really bad argument in this Hercules play,
yes,
right?
Yes, they do.
So you have to kind of like keep nudging them like the butterfly that comes in like that or something like that?
Yeah. So like they get kind of into a bad argument with each other and we try to get them back together, which in the end it works out.
So can you sing just a little tidbit?
From which song would you like to hear?
Which is your favorite?
I have to say Somebody's Got Your Back is my favorite song.
I even like the sound of that. I mean, if you had a best friend, that's what you want, right? You want someone
yeah.
who has your back.
Okay.
So go ahead.
As a teeny titan, I would dare to dream I'd be given freedom free and clear. So forgive me if I sing or make a whole big thing, but I just can't maintain my cool veneer. Then there's like a little bit of dialogue, and then Hercules sings, that I owe you, that you owe me, means we're ally, ally, oxen free, say, ain't it great to know that somebody's got your back? Oh, I always knew that I could trust you, kid. Oh, it's quid pro quo, that it's pro quo quid. I knew you'd see that fair is fair. Cross my heart and double pinky swear, say, ain't it great to know that somebody's got your back? Say, ain't it great to know that somebody's got your back?
Wow, that's very nice.
Thank you.
It take a long time to learn that?
Actually not that long, because I kind of like looked it up online since I missed a lot of the rehearsals in the beginning where you learn songs. So I was able to look it up and learn it. I learned it in like a couple of days, which I was kind of impressed about.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Now what grade are you in?
I'm in eighth grade.
And where?
I live in Quincy.
So what school do you go to?
I go to Central Middle School.
Central Middle. And so you come all the way from Quincy? And
yeah, I come all the way from Quincy here.
Yeah. And you really enjoy it. What's your favorite character in the show besides yourself?
My favorite character in the show besides the role I play, I have to say I love the Muses. I just love how sassy they are.
Mm-hmm.
And I just love, it's either between them or Persephone. I just love how she is like just a little girl, and I just love it. So it's just really funny the way she acts.
Good. So, if you could pick like one other character, what would you do?
If I could pick another character to play in the show, I would pick to play Persephone, because yeah. I just love that role so much, and one of the songs she sings is like one of my favorite songs in the show.
Now, do you work with Persephone?
Yes.
In the show for
yes,
Hercules' behalf?
Yeah, we spend a lot of time together in the show, me and Persephone. At one point, that's like we basically help get Meg and Hercules back together. We become friends during this adventure. We both help Hercules along this way, so yeah.
And what color are you in the show?
I do not know. I haven't known that yet.
Okay, so I think they said they would give colors to people.
Yeah.
I don't know why that helps signify or symbolize a certain character trait
yeah.
or something.
I haven't learned what mine is yet. So.
Okay. Well, I'd like to end the interview with you inviting the audience to come on and see you play.
Okay.
So maybe you could just speak right to the camera.
Come on and see Hercules, everybody. You're not gonna regret it.
Thank you very much. Nice job. Thank you. Hi, I'm here with Hannah Rue at the Little Theatre of Stoughton's production of Hercules. Hannah, how excited are you?
I'm super excited.
Yeah?
So what's
your role in this presentation?
I am Hades, which is the ruler of the underworld.
Aha. Does that like bring out the negative deep side of you?
I guess I get to be evil because I'm not really evil in real life, so it's like I get to act.
So tell me a little bit about the show and the kids in it and how much fun you're having.
Okay, well, first off, I was saying everybody's very talented, and it's going to be a great show.
Yeah.
But it's basically about Hercules and his little adventure and me trying to stop that little adventure. So, I'm not a very nice person in the show, so.
Now, I read some notes that your favorite, like, sort of acting thing you'd like to do is Sweeney Todd.
Yes.
Sweeney Todd shirt. I even listened to what Sweeney Todd's about a little bit, and I was, like, cringing. It was, like, making my skin crawl.
It's Sweeney Todd and Hamilton are, like...
So tell me about Sweeney Todd. I know it's not this show, but it's like, how crazy? Why am I so, like, freaked out about this?
Okay, well, it's about a Sweeney Todd, the bloody demon barber of Fleet Street.
Yeah, those are a barber? And what does that barber do?
Well, he wants to kill everyone, basically.
He cuts their hair and he kills them?
Basically.
Oh, my God. So we're not doing that show, but I was...
No.
When I heard that you liked that, I said, oh, on one thing, I'm not giving this girl a pair of scissors. That's all there is to it. And now it's sort of related to Hades because...
A little bit.
Yeah, Hades is kind of devilish, mm-hmm. right? Maybe not, like, trying to kill the people they work with, but maybe that's okay, too. I don't know. So give us the most dastardly thing you do in this play.
I don't know. You'll see a lot of facial expressions.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
And, like, big movements, like...
And that's going to help to convey,
yeah.
like, how much you're trying to trip up Hercules.
Mm-hmm. It's a very funny character, although he's evil. He's very funny, just, like, the way he moves and everything.
Wow. I'm so excited for you. Now, this is your second, is this your second
yeah,
show?
Yeah, this is my second show.
And you did Willy Wonka before this?
I did.
Yes. So how do you find yourself being attracted to this whole idea of little theater? What is it about that?
It's this whole... Theater is like a community, like we're a family, and it's like, hey fam, that's like what we like just like randomly like say. I don't know, we all like feel like home. Some other theaters you can feel like that, but I mean with this theater you can really tell that everyone loves each other, so it's just great.
That's great. Now, your favorite subject in school, what is it?
It's health.
Health?
I love medical stuff.
You love medical stuff. So yes. That sounds like you might become a doctor.
Maybe.
But I'm thinking that what's the kind of doctor that finds out what kills people?
A diagnostician.
It's something, what do they call it? I can't think of the name, but I think you make a good one of those.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so before we go, would you just tell the audience, maybe you can catch the camera full and square, and tell them when exactly the show is, and how they could get tickets, which I think is littletheatreofstoughton.org.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay, well, the show is 3rd, 4th, and 5th. We have 4 shows, and you can buy tickets online or at the door. They're at the door, too, so make sure you get here, buy tickets, and see the show, because it's going to be really awesome. We've got a lot of talented people.
Well, thank you so much for being on the show, Hannah.
Thank you.
You're a great interview.
Thank you.
All right.
Wet as a warthog's backside. But thick as you are, pay attention. My words are a matter of pride. They are from a vacant expression. The lights are not all on the stands. But we're talking kings, successions. Even you can't be caught unawares.
We'll be prepared.
Wait, for what?
For the death of the king. No, for the death of Zeus.
Is he sick?
No, we're gonna kill him. And Hercules, too.
Great idea.
Who needs a king?
No king, no king. Yeah. La, 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 la.
There will be a king.
But I will
be king. Stick with me, you'll never worry about anything again.
Anything can happen, it's official. You can choose the super or the superficial.
Anything can happen.
Thank you for watching Little Theatres of Stoughton Hercules play. And if you want to buy tickets, they are online. And if you saw the actors playing in the background, they worked really hard. And I think you should be very proud of them. And I'm your co-host, Elle Dubois, and my grandpa is Steve Kelly.
Thank you very much for watching our show, and we hope that you'll get tickets at littletheatreofstoughton.org. The show is March 3rd, 4th, and 5th. It's at the Stetson Hall in Randolph. Co-produced by Sarah Flanagan and adapted by Kelly McGrath. The show is Hercules. We know you'll have a great time. Please come out and support the kids. Buy a ticket and you'll have a blast.